Coin Toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. Caught at the 8. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
The defenders are really going to have to get their heads into this game. That was a big play, and on first down, no less.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 43. Nice run there. He's got it with room to run. Tackle made at the 43. The pass is complete for 7 yards, and that'll be a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 43. Tackled after a decent pickup. That's a gain of 4. That makes it 2nd and 6. Third and 1, ball on the 34. Makes it out to about the 23.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
Make the stop around the 13-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. And he's tackled at the 12-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 12-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 15.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
To me, that's on the quarterback. He's got to be able to recognize and use his eyes and vision to be able to see that the corner is coming on a blitz. The offense didn't do a good job of picking up the blitz, but the quarterback's got to be able to see that and make the throw quickly to get the ball before the corner can sack him.
Fourth and long here after the sack. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. The kick is up, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. It's
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
And that's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 29-yard line. Throws this one away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Mike four. Five wide. Down. Get to that quickly. And down he goes at the 46-yard line. The defense might be licking their chops right now, Herbie. We've got a change at the quarterback position. We know the kid is talented, but you got to know the defense is going to come after him. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 46. Makes it to the 44. It up the middle for a nice run from the 40-yard line. It's first down. Loss of one there for the halfback.
That is a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
They come out in a five-wide set. He's taken down around the 23-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 23. To the tailback, and they're in. Touchdown.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They got to get on their toes.
On the extra point. An 8-play, 69-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one, and it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. Bring him down around the 20-yard line.
I think the corner is the toughest position to play in football. You have to be athletic enough to be able to run with wide receivers and willing to be able to come up and make plays like this to be able to stop the run. This is a big-time play by a corner, showing the versatility to be able to come up and be physical in the run game.
We played one quarter. The Buffaloes lead 7-3. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
You know, as a defender, anytime you're not going to have a chance to get to the quarterback, one of the things all defensive coaches try to teach their defense is to get your hands up and try to knock the football away. And that time, that's exactly what they did to set up this fourth down.
And this one is a beauty. He drops it.
That's a tough break. Whether you lose the ball or not, it can mess with your head when that happens.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Set, down, hut, move 42, hut.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Four down. Mike four.
Brought down at the 46. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. Taken down at the 47-yard line. Gain of a yard by the fullback.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
Calls for the fair catch. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Outside after a nice pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Somebody jumped early down there.
False start. Offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
From their own 13-yard line, third down. He's tackled at the 22. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he can't hang on to the ball. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Around the 29-yard line. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what? That was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
It's second down now. 13 to go. Ball on the 29. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle made at the 37-yard line.
Man. Mike four.
gets rid of this one. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
A really defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style of game plan. The offensive coordinator, take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it.
Now, the quarterback has to be careful here not to leave his receiver so vulnerable like that. He took a licking right there.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. And they make the stop at the 38.
That's a gain of 6 on the play.
Not over here.
Third down.
Not over here.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46. He gets rid of this one. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. He lets it fly. It's the sophomore that's got it, and he's tackled at about the 19-yard line.
It definitely put them in better field position, and I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
Not much gained on that play because this safety did a wonderful job of getting up there and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
And they get nice yardage on that run. They come out in an empty backfield. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes at the 13-yard line. They're going to go for the easy three here. Kicks up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Makes it out to about the 40. Points were very hard to come by in those first two quarters. They'll head to the locker room. The Buffaloes lead 7-6.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. I'm a fan of seeing guys one-step rep, two-step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David, but could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense, too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese? Sometimes, pretty good defense makes, average offenses look really, really bad. But, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well, and, don't let them throw the fastball, make them throw the curve. And you see great defenses be able to do that all the time, and that's when you can be ultra successful. You have to find ways to make people play, the game out of their comfort zone.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. And it's a short kickoff. They'll bring him down at the 32. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Here's a run. Gets to about the 34-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
And it's difficult to run on this defense when they put this kid up in the box.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 34-yard line. Runs left and quickly taken down. The catch and gets out of bounds. It's first and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. He's at the 40. He's at the 30, to the 20, the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown.
Wow. When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
He makes the PAT. To kick this one away. Field it at the 9. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a t-shirt that says finish. Finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to the opponent's territory.
Picks up a yard.
That brings up second and 9.
We've got a second and 9 here. Ball on the 26-yard line. Got a man. Watch out here. He's taken down at the 35.
With the catch. That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
Nice run to the outside.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 39. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
The sophomore just stuck it to the ball carrier right there. That's a very good tackle.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide. And they got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Won't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going. Well, Kirk, we saw this kid head to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, and now we see he's back on the sideline. That's good news. Looks like he should be able to get back in the action. Fires it out. He's knocked out of bounds at the 38-yard line.
First down.
From the 38-yard line, first down.
My four.
Deep ball, laying it out there. He caught it for the touchdown.
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play.
Here we go. They'll try to tie it up right here with a 2-point conversion. They don't get it. So the 2-point conversion is no good.
Here they try to put the ball in the air. Unfortunately, they were unable to convert.
Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 32. Tackled after a decent pickup. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Oh, excellent punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Here's an opening. Brought down at the 48.
Gaining 26 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. He laterals. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it. The back didn't have any room to run. Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38. And he's taken down at the 49-yard line. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. He fields the punt at the 16, and down he goes at the 21. A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. The Buffaloes in front by two. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21. He's tackled at about the 17-yard line. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From their own 17-yard line, third down. The sack.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game. When he made the decision to return the ball, I'm sure he thought there was going to be some room to run. But boy, did it vanish in a hurry. Still, he got something out of it.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver. Touchdown, and that's going to give him the lead.
These poor guys in the secondary look like they're still trying to catch up with him. He's gone in a heartbeat.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the 2-point conversion. He's in for the conversion. For the kickoff. From the 7. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Here's an opening. Tackle at the 42. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
First and 10. Ball on their own 42. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. Inside the 30. Tackle made right around the 22-yard line. So we've got a first down after a great running play. Inside the 10, and he's tackled at the 5-yard line. Stop at about the 3-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
From the 3-yard line, it's second down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. And down he goes at the 3. Defense stacked in tight here. Ball pops for it. We got a tie ball game.
These blocking backs do a lot of dirty work during the game, so it's good to reward them. Let them barrel it in for a score once in a while.
The kicker on the field. He'll try to put his team up by a point. And he converts the extra point. A 6-play, 72-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
So the score now, 21-20. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. It's fielded at the 2. He gets hit out of bounds around the 22-yard line. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22.
Offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Got hit and still completed it. They'll bring him down at the 22. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he can't get the pass off, and he's sacked.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
The 10. Nice run, and he's brought down. The defense calls a timeout. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. defense might have just run out of chances with that first down right there.
This offensive line definitely left it all on the field today.
Defense and their short yardage package. And he gets the touchdown. The offense didn't get the playoff in time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just under two to go in the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A short kickoff. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. And the defense stopped them cold on fourth down during their last drive.
That stop gave this defense some momentum last time out. It'll be interesting to see if they can keep that intensity on this drive.
He's taken down around the 44-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Brought down at the 46-yard line.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
With room to work. Wants to go long and done. And that just might do it. Intercepted.
As a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
From their own 19-yard line, first down. We have less than a minute to go. Favorite play in football if you're a quarterback. Take a knee. The defense calls a timeout. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. Nice run up the middle. To win, a really tough one to lose. 28-20 Buffalo. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.